fly in, then they fly out. Gun. Chop, chop, chop it up, you know what we about. Whoosh. Chop, chop, chop it up, you know what we about. Gun. Chop, chop, chop it up, you know what we about. All right, then, you know what's going on. Chat Shop Podcast back again. Me and Keem, tag team champions, Hardy Boys Business. You know what I mean? And big up all my sponsors. Big up the birthday boy, Chef Walla, big and his Strong. Caribbean Nice, always make you nice. The Neutralizer, I've been burning beer weed in here, so you know the Neutralizer is coming proper.
Boxed installation
for all you. And that one. And Mr. P, big up Mr. P. Right now, I want to introduce my guest, my latest guest to the show. Big up Mr. Dylan Duffus, a.k.a. D-Boy.
A.k.a.
Take your shirt off in the club.
No, shit.
All of them ting them at home.
Shit, just, you know, when the juice kicks in.
When the juice kicks in, you know what's going on. But yeah, man, welcome to the ting, the pod, with me and my bro, Keem. Mm-hmm. You get me?
Thank you for having me, gentlemen. You get me?
You're welcome, man. You're welcome.
You get me on sales as well. Sorry, you
get China
me.
Thing, man.
Man, I got me high side. I just kick in there.
Yeah,
forgot.
Man, tell him.
Action, I'm still.
Yeah, but you kind of zoned out. Tell him about hospitality. Tell him about
hospitality. But yeah, man, hospitality is mad, man. Mm-hmm. You get me? I go many different interviews and many different places. Mm-hmm. You get me? And right now, you get me? It's mad.
It's
full. I'm watered, fed. You get me?
Yeah,
I get me everything else medicated.
Mm-hmm.
You get me juiced up. You know, yeah, get man. Me. You get me? It's a bit.
You never get this treatment.
I need my bed right now.
You shit. Never get this treatment when you went to the House of Parliament. Yeah,
blood, I never. Blood, come on, man. Nah, it was mad still. I was sipping some teas and so, you know, some fruits was mad organic and shit. It was different in there because. Different thing. You get me? I've got a bottle walking around. You get me? Didn't see the man with like drinking with one.
Yeah.
Different environment because. Yeah, that's.
Nah, seeing you, man. You had your blazer on.
Yeah, just feeling kind of calm, you get me?
Nah, yeah, that man, yeah, that's what's going on, man.
Nothing, man, I'm out here, you get me, living, breathing, you get me, so I'm blessed, everything else is a bonus, my brother, man. I'm good, man.
So I'll go on with the acting thing, any films?
Yeah, I've got something coming out, what's the 16th of, something I mean, got a little cameo win, what's it called, Against All Odds, it'll be out the 16th of November. You kind of tell, it's like a kind of grime story thing, it's like, it's going to be on Channel U and all of that there, so look out for
okay.
that. That's coming real
soon. Channel U's made a return.
And them and everybody in the team, say that again.
Channel U's made a return now, innit?
Yeah, man, that's what I'm seeing, you get me, but
so they put the movie on there.
Part of the history, you get me, so big up the man, even though I'm in there for a little role in there, but I'm in there,
yeah,
you get me,
yeah,
you're not playing the informer again, no?
Nah, man, none of the police thing right now. You get me, boy? You get me?
Are they the roles you go for, though? Because most of the time, though, obviously, I respect your acting thing like a thing.
Nah, before we, no, we can't do that. You can't do that. Wait, stop, hold on. Before we do that, I want to know some of your acting
coming from
background.
Early, you know.
That's what I'm saying. This is what's going on here. I want to know some of the acting background. What's the background?
What's the background?
There's no acting skills.
There's no. All right, tell the truth.
So, hold on. So how did you get into this thing? What was your first film?
What's my first film? One Day.
One Day. So how did that one come about?
The stories behind that is...
Tell us the story behind that.
There's a mad story about
there's
it.
A mad story. There's a mad
but
story.
Let's hear it from the
watch the movie as well. You get me? But the story is... Like, you get me? I was chilling, you get me? Kicking back. Thinking, I need to change my life. Mm. Getting into trouble. You get me? In jail or everything. You get me? All these little things are popping up. Thinking, well, I need to do something different, fam. You get me? And all the mathematics, there's only a certain amount of time you can... You certain things, you get me? And I'm thinking, you always have to have an end game. Obviously, I've got hair by trades, and I'm thinking, I don't want to do that all day.
Yeah, Baba.
But I've always felt like, I'm Baba. True. But you get me? I've always felt like, I can make a movie.
What trim
always
you told, got?
Man.
Huh? What trim?
My trim's my hair's mad right now. He's trying to catch me out. My hair's going to die, dog.
My hair's going to die, B.
That's sorry. He's No. You get me? Shit. Throw the virus. You get me? Hair's growing to that. Man, I tried to catch me. You get me? You thought it was all mad.
Yeah, I thought it was mad.
Get me? No. I thought man, it was nice. Mad. Still in the game, player. How you mean? Fuck you, mate. But you thought the cap was a deep play.
Yeah,
you
get me?
What's going on? God damn. Yeah. These are dangerous. Whoa. For Cypher, what if you come up here? You know that? So they do get me. You get me? Yeah. I ain't slipping over you. I'm good.
Hold on, though. So boom. So what? You're barber by trade.
Yeah, barber by
trade.
So boom, yeah. I used to cut hair in that, you get me? Well, I always cut hair, you get me? Mm-hmm. So, when I was a picnic, I had to be fly, you get me? When I was young, but the barber thinks mad, you get me? Mum don't want to send me to the barbers. My nan thinks to sharp up some Mark of the Beast thing, so it's mad going to the barbers. My nan saying, let's cut it straight like this. Like, the fuck? The Mark of the Beast, you get me? So, he's all mad, I had to learn how to cut hair and shit.
Yeah.
You see me? So, yeah, man, it's mad. So, from there, living, doing what I'm doing, thinking, shit, I need to change my life, you get me? not doing the right stuff. You understand? Yeah, yeah, didn't go to school, grew up in a certain environment. You get me? Or just in the midst of everything, thinking, yeah, right, yeah, see everything that's going on. You get me? I need to do something different. But fuck it, I've always told my man, I'm gonna be a movie star. You know, I'm gonna make films. You know.
So one day one day.
Now me and Penny woke up. I was just
Penny, famous Penny.
Yeah,
Penny. So
old type Penny.
Get me big.
So what did Penny do? 1 mile away and one day.
Yeah, so that's where I met her from one day.
Okay.
She was in the area doing research for a film that she wanted to do, you get me? But I've been talking this shit from as a kid, you know, so I want to make movies, you get me? Boom. I was reaching out to people, you get me? Somebody said that there's a youth interested in making a film, but she was doing research on in the B6 side of town.
Nah, I just really had a cough there. Serious.
Coronavirus and shit.
Strong weed, I'm smoking, yeah.
She was in B6, then.
Yeah, so the man, they thought she was the police, you get me? But I got introduced to her through somebody I know as a fisher, you get me? That's in the game, you get me?
So wait, back up a bit. So originally, we're saying one day was going to be based kind of over Aston Ray.
It was a little story.
There was no story. Oh, they just went over there to find the story.
She's just doing research as a director. You get me? She's got her own story behind that. You get me? She wanted to get into the community. What's going on? Boom.
Yeah.
I met her. You get me? Sat down with her. Gave her a story. You get me? You get me? She put it together. You get me? She done what she done with it. So, and then we come with one day.
So
I thought it's going to be a joke thing. You get me? At first, I was thinking, shit, there's going to be a couple cameras. We know ain't going to be going on in that.
So did you choose the man that you wanted to be in the film?
I'm going to tell the truth. I wanted it to be a different kind of thing, but the man that did it, big up everybody, because that's what made it. But the truth of the situation is, when I was doing it, everybody, remember, I'm walking around piece of paper, flying, saying, I got auditions for a film, and that nobody's taking me serious and that, you get me? And then the trucks pulled up, you get me? Then you get me, he's mad, you get me? So then it was. But the people that got involved in the film was actually the industry at the time, like Esquad. Who else was there? Big up Esquad, big up Lady Leisha. You get me? You get me? YT, big up Pess, you get me? You get me? So, everybody, man. How can I forget the lady's name? The rapper girl.
Stop forgetting people, man.
Sorry, man. Big up you. Yeah, she one day, man, the rapper.
Rapper, the girl.
Lady Leisha, you asked the other one that's rapping. Sorry, man.
Dark skin girl.
Yeah. Sorry. These like smoking with the weed and that. I can't remember the woman's name. I love you anyway. Thank you, but everybody, get me that. You get me? It was auditions and shit. Mm. That's how I wasn't meant to be in the film. I wasn't meant to act in the film. You get me? I'm thinking, cameras and shit. Like, the fuck is this?
I took pictures
for like 10 years before that. You get me, bro? The fuck? You get me? So, boom. I was helping out in the auditions. Then Penny says, "You know something? You might as well take the lead in the film." And then,
before Penny said, you might as well get involved in the film," you was backseat doing.
I just was just helping out, just doing my thing.
Not helping out.
Sorry. I was part of the production company.
That's
the production. So he's doing pre-production.
My next
for the film.
Question is now because you said you had part to play in the writing.
Yeah.
So figure wise, is yours was looking all right? Did everybody get paid?
Everybody got paid. We got this film cost £750,000 to make. Yeah. I mean, about £750,000 to make.
One day cost that?
After distribution, Everybody got paid. I got paid for my production work. I got paid for everything. You get me my script? Because it was called script consultancy at the time. And then I got, but what happened was the film got bootlegged, so we never made no money. That was the problem.
Okay.
You get me? Everybody's watched the film. The thing's mad. You would think the thing done a madness, but remember, we watched on the bootleg.
In cinema.
You got banned. Remember, it's the
first, the gangbangers
trying to fuck it, and the police shut it down, saying that man are trying to glamorize their lifestyle, and all that kind of bullshit. Obviously, I took it out and I made a movie out of it.
What type of figures were we talking though?
I'm just curious. Do your thing first. Act first time.
Yeah, like,
thing called, for actors, there's a thing called actors' equity. So,
tell
for us first time actors' equity, it's not, and it's probably a couple bills a day. So if you're working for every day for the month or whatever, 2 months and whatever, not you get me. That's every day.
Is that your pay for your acting?
And then you'll have something like then you'll get like if your contract's correct, you'll get something. The film makes money. And then every time it's licensed to somewhere,
basically
every
different
time it's
levels.
Released, or every time it's played somewhere, you'll get something out of it. Film has to recoup first.
Okay,
so that's what the problem was.
Okay, so after that, then you went into intern. In it was 1 mile away before that though.
After that,
Away before intern.
1 mile was
set the scene for me. You just done one day.
Yeah.
How old are you?
26.
26, you just decided you want to change your life around. I always wanted to be an actor.
Yeah.
I'm in the film. I'm lead. Yeah. I must be feeling myself.
Nah, he was, bro. I seen him. Bro, this is back in the day before Noom. He's like, yo,
I'm not keeping 100. Tell him.
Was it Club Indulgence? You had the party.
I can't remember shit.
I swear he was in some white blazer, blood. Shades.
You know what I mean?
Shit. You know, white blazer, shades, beer, champers,
blood. You know, like that. Look at me. I was young and wild, bro.
Let's have a drink for that one.
D-boy now, you baby D-boys. That's wild, bro.
Alright then, so everybody's saying, baby D-boy is born at this point.
Yeah,
it's kicking in, bro. Baby D-boy is born at this point.
Nah, man, I've always been that nigga, man.
Yeah, but now we're a movie star.
Bro, in my head, I've always that guy. Yeah, listen to me. I know what you're saying. I was all in my head.
But now everybody sees you. Now everybody can see.
Man, they see me, but they're just thinking this youth just needs to get me, and I'm around certain things. So you get me, I go certain places. I'm probably just in the corner in the back, just acting up and just trying to elbow me. Behave yourself, man. Mm. What are you doing that in the dance floor going on with you? Mm. Well, you get me? Now I'm free with it. Like, you get me? Nobody costing me. You're off the table, D-boy. Now, man, let me do these things. You're a superstar. Yeah, I'm telling you, bruh. Binter, you get me?
That's how you're feeling. That's really, so you're 26 like, and 20, yeah, you just got everything going on.
But it was my blood. Listen to me at first, though. Remember, I went jail just before it come out and all sorts of shit. You get me? So in my head, listen to me, bro. I've watched a movie, and at first, you get me, I wasn't too sure about the rapping and all that. The film's hard as nails. You get me? But it just was a bit uncomfortable because that wasn't my idea. Wasn't my thing. So I had to. You get me? I didn't really under. You get me? So I had to absorb it and take it in. So but when it bossed and everybody was. But the thing is, I was kind of pissed in it because it's a big. You get me? Because while it could have been, please shut it down.
I don't think it should have been a musical.
Yeah, I know, man. That did piss me off to be fair.
Brother,
yeah,
I want to tell the truth. That's a, when I've watched that, I'm a bit awkward about it.
Man, a banging.
Imagine you're from the block, Kenny. Imagine you're from the place. Imagine you're from the place and you just know this is coming out. It's beer rapping and you're not really too sure about it. And now you get me. So I'm a little bit, obviously, I'm gassed, but I'm just thinking, I don't know how the place is going to take it in. You understand it, bro? But then, obviously, I'm making a movie, so you get me?
It's fucking same time. But as a viewer as well, same time, I'm thinking, why am I rapping for, man?
Yeah, it was Penny's idea, but see, the rap man thing, everything now, that's the future.
It's true, you get me?
We just couldn't see the vision because we're from a dark place. So
Caribbean, nice, keep it nice.
Big them up.
Yeah, that's true still. I rate that still.
Red rum.
Yeah, so boom then. So you never had no acting skills.
Red rum to blood club. It's a cold. It's a cold. Nick, come get me. I'm joking. Yeah,
so you never had no acting experience.
Nah, fam. Yeah, just waking up in the morning, having stressed out and still having to touch road and still having to fucking be around the gorillas and the goons and that and still function, car. There's no cousins, no aunties, no uncles, there's no big brothers, just me in the midst, you get me? So I'm just bubbling and just in the, you get me? I don't know nobody else, so I'm just in the place. So sometimes.
Right now,
nice.
There's a scene.
When I said red rum, you should have knew it was a rat. Fuck. Your white rum.
Oh, yeah, there's a scene in one day when you're right, man. You look stressed out in the car.
Bro, it's like all real. Like, listen to me. Yeah. I'm going to tell the truth. The situation I could talk. Get me? I shouldn't be doing it, but the situation, I took it out. So they get me. I took it out. So you see what happened when man, I get in the yard and going to do something in the house and then I don't get into incriminate myself allegedly. You get me? You get me? So boom, bam, boom. Fucking, you get me? And you get me? My brother just said, my brother just did not there. I'm because like, niggas I grew up with like the fucking, you get me? What the fuck? Man, had to keep the money, you know, like that. So it was all real, so I could draw from them emotions, certain places, and certain times, and certain things. Car, it was what it was.
That's good stuff.
So then, after one day, it was. How did you link up with Nicky Slim thing and them type of man there? Car, you seem to pop up in all types of films with what?
You know what happened? Stuff. Slim hollered at me. I was in London one time. I was doing some course for some UK citizens, big them up as well. Some. Different kind of politics shit, but fucking, I still have to say that, but yeah, yeah, but boom, yes, yeah, so I met Slim. Slim said, yo, I'm doing some movie stuff and I'm doing this, that, and the third. I said, all right, cool, B. I said, he wants to link me. Sorry, my fucking old belly's out. Nah, yeah, man's gonna, no one's gonna say nothing. Just gonna watch it back. Like, why not? We get me our boxes and that. Yeah, fix up myself. Hold on, hold on, come on, come on. I've got your media training and all that.
You're killing it right now.
Shit, but yeah, boom. So yeah, get me. The man hit me up and said, "Yo, D boy, like, get me." They didn't know him properly, but you get me. Said, "Yo, they're doing their film thing and whatnot." Mm. Obviously. I see the vision, you get me, and it's difficult. When I first come into this, I didn't know there's no avenues, there's no nothing.
Yeah.
I had to go on, like, I was doing, like, just music videos, so I'm following, going to Jay-Z's, Ever Young, and Rihanna's Tia Temeroff. I was shooting, like, Naomi Campbell's 40th birthday party in the south of France.
When you say you was going to these
videos. I just were working behind the scenes, the production companies. Oh, you're like, hanging around, yeah, just, you get me, just okay, get me to sign up with the production company, mm-hmm, obviously, you get me. Mm-hmm. We got, what's it called, Rebel State, you get me?
Yeah, all of them,
for taking my experience. But yeah, man, one of the mad thing.
Okay.
But just to understand the game, because remember, I'm fresh off the road, mm-hmm, bro. Yeah. I don't know nothing, Axe SG. Mm-hmm. A lie? Mm-hmm. You get me? I'm just, I don't know much, you know, I didn't go to school, you get me, bro? My environment's very small, because like I said, I don't have the network of the family here, there, mm-hmm, and everywhere, so I'm just in the place, you understand it, bro? Yeah, so my environment was very small until that moment, you get me?
True.
Yeah,
all right, then, so if that's how you linked up, man, then, innit?
Yeah, so, yeah, sorry. Sorry, yeah, so back to Slim. We got Nicky Slim thing, boom.
Yeah,
so I met Slim, he was fucked, you get me? So I met Slim, he said he's making this movie thing, he wants to do the thing. He was going to do a film called Money and Grime, you get me? Mm, then, yeah. Hopefully he still gets to do that, but that never happened. And he hit me up again and said, "Yo, I got this film called The Intent, and I wanted to play like a police officer." Then he hit me with, "What's that film with?
Why are you thinking? Why are you thinking?
Oh, In Too Deep.
In Too Deep.
Oh, that's the role he sent
me with. And then he hit me with the Denzel Washington. Then I seen Dylan Duffus.
Right,
I thought Dylan Duffus under them kind of names. You know, I remember that Dylan Duffus and them man they did. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So
yeah,
that list there, that way or that, but probably the Denzel on top. But yeah, but you get me.
Mm.
What it is.
So that part sticky, you know.
And the thing is, you get me, I come from the place, so for me to do that and push on my face all day, it's quite, you get me, simple, and just give that energy and just, that's not, you get me, so I thought I could take it a little bit.
In that one, you're rolling with the mandem, but you're fed in it.
Pussy clock snake.
How you feel about that? Obviously, yeah, actor. I know it's a silly question, but I just want to ask anyway. How you feel about playing an informer?
How did you get into character for that?
How you get into character to play a good informer? Not just a good one. Dodgy guy. Dodgy guy. That's what it was, isn't it? I come from Handsworth, mate. Yeah, it's a bunch of dodgy guys. You get me, and the man are lovely. Everybody, the man, I'm sorry, let me take that back. Give me some love. This is lovely, but fuck you, mate. Shit, I like all of you niggas, but you're the fuck up. Yeah, you get me. Like I said, everybody's putting a performance on, and it's not a performance like that, but you know, like, you have to be to survive. Yeah, you have to be dodgy. Yeah, you get me, you have to be, you get me, just. Yeah. So I drew from that experience in life, and gave it to them, but and then they put the police name on top, so it just worked, you get me? So that was the police thing on top. But throughout the most of the film, I'm just doing just the calm in the background, kind of just mingling in, you get me? That was kind of the energy and vibe that they wanted from it, so that's what we got.
Yeah, no, proper, man. You could see you on Netflix and all them things now, yeah?
Say that we shot that in 2 weeks as well, so we got 2.5 weeks, so that's a big
one. 2.5 weeks?
Yeah, 2.5 weeks, my thing.
The intern got shot in 2.5 weeks. That's big business, man.
Yeah, man, it's my thing, bro.
Rate that, man. Have a drink for that as well, man. We're drinking up tonight, man.
We're gonna be shit.
Turning up tonight,
my thing, yeah.
Yeah, the boy.
No, building for the ladies.
For the ladies, big man. Oh, So, all right then. So, at this point now, you got a couple films under your belt.
Yeah, I got
a couple films under your belt. Things are going well. Must be. It looks it. Stop. Don't tell me if they are or not. But it looks like things are going well. Yeah. Man are going cinemas and man are seeing you in trailers and whatnot.
On the big
screen. So are the girl them. So are the girl them, innit? So are the girl them. So at this point now, where are we with the girl scene and that? Like, are you still like?
See what it is. You see what I call it? You see, I've lived a few lives, innit?
You mean before, a few?
So when I was young,
yeah,
I got. Big up on my baby mothers, isn't it?
How much you got?
500 million. I love all of my baby mothers. If I keep looking after the kids and that. For real talk, you get me?
Have a drink for the kids.
Yeah, have a drink.
And the baby mothers.
Before we dissect
Dylan,
that
big
one.
Big up Dylan, Shanti, before we dissect Donna, that one. Rico, Day, Rolly, Callie, Zion. Say ACR and big them all up, the love. Yeah, yeah, love.
You got five baby mums and how many kids?
10 of them.
10?
10. What, two by each?
No,
listen.
Straight to deep, man.
So this is what they mean when they say D-boy. This is the D-boy.
No, it
is.
I've been D-boy because my name was Dylan.
No.
They've to different kind of things.
Bro, let me dissect the thing for my people, them, how they know we do the thing. So you now, you came movie star, yeah.
my kids are my oldest is 23 because he's nearly as big as you, brother. He's big. My kids probably is bigger than us.
That's how you're moving.
Bigger than everybody in the eyes. Whoa.
I know, but at one point you must have thought, yo, I'm fucking Dylan Duffus. I'm an actor, bruv. I'm doing what I want to do.
Bro, nah, I've already done all of that.
Nah, but
when I was young, I was wild.
I can't compare music to young boy.
But you know what it is, bro? It's not even as a big man. I understand this, and this is what I have to have us understand, young man. Sex is a bit deeper than just fucking.
All right,
so you know what it is. See, if I'm, I have to have an, I have to have like a connection to you, like a spiritual kind of, some kind of energy, kind of.
Yeah, yeah.
You have to have that. Drink the drink, bro.
Please.
Let me spare us.
Spare us.
No, I'm after eating the game.
Now I'm talking about in the prime time of Dylan.
You just said you're in the south.
Yeah, exactly. What's he on about?
I know they're nice little ones.
What are you talking about with the models and doing what I do and all of that kind of like? It was mad, bro. Get me black eyes.
That's what I want. That's the part I'm talking about.
Like, I mean, there's some £63 million yacht.
Just Ewa.
Quincy Jones' son is like, they're having a conversation about something. Get me, this mad bro. Some
these are the rooms you're in. This is what I'm saying.
Like some gangster shit, bro.
Some gangster shit.
Bro, on some speedboat over to the yacht. Shoes and shit together.
That's what I'm talking about. Them times there, you wasn't talking about babes. I need a connection with you. That's what I'm talking about.
D boy was on some D boy business.
You know what it is.
Oh, you're giving us the politics.
I'm not even going to give you the politics. Get me? It's not even the politics, my baby. You know what I mean? I'm
going to get in trouble.
Nah, man. I'm occupied, cuz.
All right, safe.
No, all right, man's occupied, cuz.
All right, safe. We don't want to get back into that.
It was the... Yeah, come on, man.
We don't want to talk about that. All right, then. Backchat.
If you heard anything, let me know.
I ain't even picked up the iPad, my bro.
Oh, shit.
I ain't even picked up the iPad.
Shit, then.
I haven't picked up the iPad. Bro. Yeah, we're second in. All right, let's get back to that, then. I'm in the baby father's union. I want to know, yeah? A man with 10 newts, kids, big kids, couple big, where? Nash your fees and that. Your kids ain't, like, wild ages. There must have been a time where... Nursery fees was kicking. You rubbing your head? Right? Them times.
I'm gonna tell the truth, my brother. You see what it is? I tried to stay because I'm at home. God, my job entitles me to be around enough. So I've been blessed in a situation where I can have the kids around me as much as possible.
Until it was
free.
Stay at home, baby father.
Stay home, baby.
Freelance, baby father.
Can you cook?
That's another thing, though. You get me? That's the only other thing.
You can't have 10 youths.
Bro, my baby mama's a sick family. Do you get me?
Why you get on with all of them?
They're all my baby mothers. Do you get me?
Okay.
You get me? That's what I'm saying. I'm not occupied for. I got my... You get me?
Nah, hey, you're killing me over here, you know. So, stay at home, baby, before I can't cook.
My baby mamas, they make things in tubs and that. Just pull it up and ready. Just warm it up and that.
Hold on. So what baby mother cooks the best?
That's how we live in it. Sometimes it is. I don't like flesh and that. You get me? You see dead and the meat and that. So you get me? Once I start squeezing, I'm thinking about this now.
So what baby mother's food do you look forward to the most?
Well,
just give them. You don't gotta say a name. Just say it in what order.
Nah, man, they all cook deliciously, man.
Yeah, but there must be one that just seasoned the thing a little bit different.
You know what it is, fam? My baby mamas, you see, every time, real talk.
Yeah,
like blessed. My baby mamas are all like this. Just they're like when it comes to they're like the proper. You get me? The moms in it. Like that's what I have to mad respect the mothers. Like that comes first. That's why I've been blessed to be in a situation where them kind of things I take for granted. Cause if I ever didn't have them, I'll be fucked. Not fucked, but you know, like I've been so blessed. I've never had to worry about certain things. I'm coming there, I'm doing this, they've blessed me, fam. So I'm good, man. Big up my baby mother. Let's have a drink for that.
Big up the baby mother.
Big up the baby mother. Big up
all the baby mothers out there. You get me? All of you. You get me out there. I was just minding everybody's shit.
15 gun salute. Get the five baby ones and the 10 kids. Yeah? That's what we're saying.
And me as well. That's yeah. what you're fuck.
16. You know what I'm saying? No.
Occupied, B.
I hear ya. So can you give us a little mad story about how, like, anything, like, without incriminating yourself in your situations and that? Because for me, yeah, five baby mothers sounds like kind of mad.
Headache.
Don't tell me about the good times. Tell me about one bad time.
When you got ketchup. Your hair was falling.
I'm surprised you got hair on your head. Take off your hat, man. You got five baby mothers and 10 kids and you all got long hair. You got plaits.
Give me a lip. Come on, man. Yeah, man. You know my age. Shit, I don't think I am players.
You get me? Let them know, man.
Yeah, don't stress though, man. That's the thing. Do you want to hear stories? Guys, about baby mama stories?
Yeah, man.
Like, baby. Shit, my baby mama stories, man.
Smoke
when
that,
I was
man.
Young, you get me. Obviously, this get me. I've got set up. So one of them just says, "Yo, you get me." Let me shoot. Most of made friends and not friends, but started having conversations and says, "All right, then he wants to play like this."
Oh yeah, both
so
of them go
coming,
at the same
come
time.
To the yard and that, just thinking everything's calm and everything. Walking in the yard, going upstairs. I mean, just open it because it's like a flat kind of thing. Just coming to the door and that, open the door and that. Let me close the door. The booth in there. Bad man, but the wickedest thing is I'm drunk so bad I popped the handle. So now I'm fucked because I can't get out of the door, cuz. I can't get out of the room, cuz. There's a tap. Should I jump out the window and just hang down and just drop? You get me? But yeah, that's a mad story, bro. My thing's crazy, bro. Everything that you could imagine, man. But like I said, then you get me at certain times, you get me when I need them to be there. They get me, they never let me down. So, very got mad respect for them still.
Yeah, man. That's proper.
And
proper.
Even though they know I'm crazy, they deal with my crazy ass, you get me? So, you get me? Wow. Come on, man.
Of course, every time. So, yeah,
sorry,
man.
Sorry, every time I hurt Johnny Chuck.
D boy, if you got anything to say, you know, if you want anything to say on the public stage,
this is what you do as well, gentlemen. Sometimes to keep it real, I'm sorry for any times I've upset you. And all that, you get me real talk. She's on a big stage, and that, you get me.
You're one of them old school 90s R&B man, innit?
You don't get me. You get me the beat. I heard the beat kicking in my head.
That's one of them old school R&B man. You know,
I'm sorry, baby.
Mixes for the white rum, not the red rum. You get me, the white rum.
I'm sorry, baby.
So what's the playlist, man? What's the playlist you play to these girls, man? The
playlist, brother. I was about to say,
yeah, man. Nah. I know what you mean, though.
I'm telling you. You get me? You get me? Just hit them with that. You get me? Sorry, you just
hey, listen.
Jodeci first. You have to hit them to get me this water. Yeah. Warm.
Now that explains Jodeci. The open shirt thing.
Yeah, that's Jodeci. What I'm going to get. You know, bro. That's my generation. You get me? I'm from born in the early 80s. You get me? I grew up in that generation.
That does not mean you can go down in the clubs and doing all of these things and with your shirt button open.
Bad.
Yeah, true.
See, the 80s and that. But man was walking around in fucking spandexes, but cycling.
Remember when I in the 80s?
You know, them racer bikes, you know, the big racer bike things and that. I swear down, you see big grasses and that walking around with spandex and that. So, a completely different era, but you get me?
Yeah,
it's just the bait dancing music and beatboxing shirt open, just get me?
So what did you think when you had the viral moment when you ended up in most of the ghetto group chats?
With the shirt that, open. That was mad, because I get me, obviously a girl's in front of me. So let me tell you the story now.
Tell the story, because nobody can see no girls in that
you get
story.
Me? You have to, I'm going to, everybody's going to check your eyes on my Instagram page and that, and if you don't, add me up on Dylan Duff, Dylan A. Duff, and she get me Instagram card. I need to get active on socials. Everybody keeps telling me, so I'm going to try and do this shit, but yeah, boom. So if you go on there, you'll see a thing, you get me, it's one round it's the night of the fucking, the intent to release party, you get me, so I'm there, and I was winding up myself, and that, the girl's got like she's got the camera saying, D-boy, flick it over my
so
shirt,
the girl's
where you can
the
see,
shot,
yeah, she's got, she's got the camera facing me, so you get me, so I'm kind of just dancing with her, you know when they, obviously, there's a camera, but it's not a camera, you know what I'm saying, she's got a phone, I'm just winding up with the girl, and I'm just giving them the, you know, like, just doing my, you know, don't act like you don't wind down with the girl then, because what am I doing in the club?
Yeah, to R&B.
Because seriously, what am I doing in the club?
You was on some Sofa House thing though.
But boom, boom, boom. You get me? That's what it was. I can't remember the tune, but it's something like that. You get me? So I was just feeling myself. And remember, it's free Hennessy on tap, just like the rum. You get me? You get me?
Tell them, rum on tap, innit?
Free rum on tap, you get me?
Smack them normal.
Definitely, so I ain't coming down here, bro. But fucking, yeah, so. Yeah. So rum on tap. So rum on tap. Just a thought to myself as I think out loud, but yeah. You get me? Yeah, rum on fucking Hennessy on tap, sorry. Mad thing, so obviously I'm wilding out. You get me? I'm kind of gassy. I'm just watching 10-2 on the big screen and that, just thinking, shit, my mum, the big screen. I'm out here. The drink's kicking in, feeling myself, and fucking had a little moment with the gal and my recording me. So if you check, it wasn't for the man, them. It wasn't like I had a man phone. Yo, when I'm in the club, I don't like them, because I know what it is as well, you know. I know niggas go to the club and they just like to stand up with man. See, if I'm in the club.
Certain man do.
I'm not saying I'm start speaking for everybody, but I'm saying that's kind of how I see that in the culture. Now you see me, I'm in the midst with the gal, because that's what I came here for.
That's how you got
10 kids.
Have some fun.
Came for the gal.
Yeah, them came from me.
Weed billing, yeah, safe. Yeah, you know what's going on. Whole of vibes, drinking juice. We ain't talking nothing too loose. That's cool, man. That's cool.
Shit, that's got me loose off the juice now. Yeah, talking loose. Like, you ain't talking nothing too.
Nah, we're good, man. We're holding the vibe.
So listen, yeah, you had a documentary/. Film, what would you call it? 1 mile away,
like one Edinburgh Film Festival best feature film for the year. For that, so big up that to that. But
listen, sorry. When you're bigging up your awards, please do it louder so we can drink up for that. You get me?
Film Festival, you get me?
Film Festival awards.
Film festivals in the UK, but yeah, so we won that blood.
So boom, controversial for many reasons. Yeah, how did that come about? Yeah, and how was that like seen from where you're from?
Boom. Here we go. Slice it up. You get me? So, boom. Now, right now, so I grew up in the manor already. You get me?
What manor?
I've got no hands off. I've got no right to be talking this fuckery, but same time, I got to be a boy. I got 7 boys. You get me? And I grew up, they get me, they're in them place. You get me? And I can see what's going on. My oldest son's getting to a certain age. Things around him are happening. You get me? Friends are notorious. You know, like, it's getting, I can see what's happening. Boom. Get me, Shabbos hit Penny up one day saying something must happen in town, and then he's seen like some from the hood, and they've, you get me, said, you know, something, fuck that man, leave Shabbos, man. It's cool. He thought, yo, why can't we just live like this?
Yeah,
Shabbos hit Penny up, you get me.
Shabbos, hold on, Shabbos, yeah.
So,
what are you talking about, slash Shabbos?
Slash Shabbos.
Okay then. So break the story down better than that, man.
So basically, you're making it sound like Shabbos got moved to in town and phoned Penny.
Nah, he didn't. Listen, that's what you said though. Shabbos was holding, he get me his buck man in town, and he thought somebody man was gonna move to him. And then a man said, nah, fuck that. That's my man. It's cool, Chris. Boom, boom, boom. But obviously, from a certain age group, in a certain time, I mean, he's been shot twice. You get me, Shabbos. You get me. You get me. So it's anything can happen. You get. He's been to. You've been shot. You understand it. So he knows anything can happen. So for him to, you get me. The man is Chris. He's got. And he thought, why can't man just be living like this? Obviously, it was a different time.
I like that you've said that, because Shabbos gonna come up here and explain the situation.
Yeah, you get me. That's what it is.
So Shabbos a part of the Penny situation, because Sim already mentioned Penny. You know,
because remember they know. So let me rewind that.
Let me break it down for the viewers, because Penny. Simbo mentions Penny. You can dress back to episode.
Penny might need to come up here.
Yeah. Why not? Big up Penny.
Yeah. Penny, we might need you. You know, just seal off a story for us, Carl. We want to know what's going on. See what I'm saying to you. Simbo mentioned Penny.
Yeah.
Now you've mentioned Penny.
Hold on.
No, but then he's mentioned.
Penny's got the bag though, you know.
Penny's richer, isn't it?
Penny, you man got broke off with these things, don't it?
You see what happened, bro. You see what this is the situation now. So at first, it was just a thing of, it wasn't even meant to be a documentary. Like, it wasn't meant to be nothing like that. You get me? He was just thinking, you know, something, the documentary process of doing it. It was just something that came into mind, because obviously the conversations and man are saying what they're saying, and that was already out there and whatever, not, you get me? So it's put into the atmosphere anyway. Obviously, I've got no weight to be saying nothing in this motherfucking conversation. But I'm just gonna throw it in the atmosphere anyway, because I know it. You get me? I know it. You get me? I grew up in it, like I said. So I wanna know.
Sorry, wait a minute. So what type of drama did this film come with?
So when you've gone back to the ends and said, I'm linking up with Shabbos, and what's going on? I asked that, but in a nicer way.
You get me?
What are you talking about, D-boy? Fuck this.
What's my so did you have to report to the big man them and say, yo, listen,
so I have a sit down like this, you get me? I'm probably big on TV 5'8", you know. So sit up straight for this evening. So obviously I had to have a conversation with man and that, and just everybody just obviously hit me with man across me. But we know man no better, so it's not even for man, it's for man's kids growing up in it.
Yeah. So you got left, so basically,
remember, so this is 10 years ago, so I'm gonna show you the mad thing of it. So man got kids. Nephews, brothers, little brother, you know, like that, that's growing up in the thing. So when like now, 10 years later, certainly these youths are fucking them, man. They run the, you know, like it's mad, you know, like that, bro. So some of the youths, yeah, it's mad, bro. You get me? Some it's mad, bro.
So man was like, say, all right, cool, go do what you gotta do, kind of thing. Like, you got the blessing from the man them over there.
I never got the blessing, bro. Some man that said, do what you gonna do, boy, they know. Some man knows not to do my thing anyway. I'm known for
Because I was watching it, you had couple man.
There's always man behind the camera and always man popping up on set.
Now, even on the whole documentary, like, there were certain man on there that were like saying, yo, they're down with it, but is it the same energy over this side? Do you get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, obviously, the truth of the situation, see, after the documentary and that, we didn't have a firearms incident in Birmingham for 18 months. Yeah. Crime rate dropped in the violent, the gang.
Let's have a drink for that. Because these are the things you need to talk louder. Don't be whispering it.
Obviously, it's not. Obviously, it wasn't. My man was not. Like, I don't want to say like it was. But at the time, that was the statistics. Say it louder. The first time it happened in a very long time. So we can get me. I'm not saying it was just to that. We're not saying the community and everybody that was. You get me doing their thing and us knowing better and just moving a different way in it because obviously, you get me, Zim and all of them. You couldn't see on the documentaries. Everybody's auntie was fucking mad.
So what was it like meeting Zimbo like for the first time?
On the camera, cause
that was the first time you met him.
First time I met him.
Did you know you was meeting him though? Like, what was your energy that day?
It wouldn't be anything because he's not.
Zim's come anti, bruv. Zim
was on smoke.
Zim wanted smoke, bruv. Zim was on gang member. I'm not a gang member. Obviously, I grew up around the team, but obviously, there's man there. If you watch the team, there's always man behind the camera because it's not a thing of, you get me, there's man around, you know, like, obviously, not everybody's coming on the camera, there's always man around the team, you get me? So, but once you get me, it's that, you get me? I'm not just doing the thing willy nilly, like, man, everybody knows exactly what's going on.
Zim was on obviously. Smoke.
Yeah, everybody's on. Most people's on everybody, smoke. Everybody was a vibe, but obviously, at the same time, you get me. And like, we have conversations, and obviously, everybody knows if we can try and do something. They're probably not going to be the one to jump up and say this and that. And I've got a only reason I'm doing this, I got a platform, and this is another reason I made one day. I've got all of these little kids saying, yo, Flash got the bird, and Flash this, that, and Flash that. Flash, your Flash bird says something constructive. Flash just put something into environment that could be very dangerous because I grew up a minister society and all of these films, and I could influence, man, and I don't know fucking badness from nowhere, bro. From films and television and whatever. Now, you get me? I learned no fuckery from it, you know, like that, bro. That was it. You like it? You get me? It's what it is.
So when everyone was finding out, boom, you're linking up with certain man, Zimbo, and that. Obviously, you was in there with Nugs and you are psycho. How was that scene on your end?
How was that scene on my ends? Like, obviously, everybody knows what I'm doing. Man, I come into the office and everybody knows what I'm doing, bro. So I've got, there was smoke. There was a time when a man looked out my window, my mom's window was at my mom's house and that, but I don't know if it was to do with that, but it was around that time, innit, so.
You don't mind people calling you Flash?
Nah, bro, I love it, man. It's fucking crazy. Man, come on, man.
You love the limelight, innit?
I couldn't answer it, because you know how much of a blessing every time you hear that thing, bro. You're mad, lucky me. Make movies and shit, like, if I go on Netflix and the thing, I see my face, I think, fucking out. You know, like that car. It's not, you know, like my, like,
yeah, smoke
not,
some more weed, things, man.
You get
smoke
me smoke some more weed, nigga. Fresh. Thank you, my brother.
Yeah. So, how would you say that's changed today then? Like, the 1 mile away thing. Did you say you've done anything for the community? Or?
Anything for the community. I see Zimbabwe, everybody had.
Because that's how
nah, like the, I know, I know that I'm talking about. I'm talking about the youths. Them like what youths? What youths have you man changed?
He probably. I'm not saying it changed in the youths because the youths their own generation. These youths are different. But the thing is, they didn't have the fucking mentorship. It's a good thing and a bad thing in a certain way because the way the place was programmed before. Mom would fucking if you're around, if it was this different, you'd have access to what a 40-50 year old nigga man was got.
You've got
access, so the whole fucking hierarchy and whole setup of the thing and organization probably be. And like I said, man, never change it like that because obviously things are different. Everybody's in jail and things happen. But if there was a, if it was that these youths here, but everybody youths are different, and they're their own entity. They're not They're their own entity. Mm. Even that, you know, like niggas is gangbanging in their own areas and shit. Like, it's mad, bro. It's different, bro.
But that's what I'm saying. Zim did touch on that. That's what he was saying. Like, the whole point of squashing the whole beef thing was kind of dead because all the mentality of the thing ain't going to change. You get me? Which is kind of true.
But to say that, for you know what the magic thing is, and you just said it there, Zimbo said it. That says it off.
We're going to get Zimbo back up here soon.
You understand it?
I Zimbo, don't, you know. Elaborate.
Let me show you something. Zimbo said it. That said it. Do you know what Zimbo is?
Yeah.
You understand it? So for Zimbo to be saying that, the fuck do you mean? Ain't that progression? Mm. Ain't that progression, my brother? If you see something happen, say it's one person or somebody or this person or that person or just has a different spark in somebody that was heading in the wrong direction or, you know, like that, bro. And I'm not saying it did and I'm not saying it changed it'd be anything because the hood was different anyway. Things was broken down and you get me, the infrastructure wasn't how it used to be anyway. You understand it? So I'm not saying 1 mile away is just that reason. You understand it? There's so many different factors, but for the simple fact of man try to, as a man, you should always try and do your best to, you know, better the situation. Yeah, that
now, I've seen the point of it. I've seen why he's done it. You get what I'm trying to say?
And but I think it had, like I said, for Zimbo, do you know who Zimbo was? If you watch the documentary, like I said, Zimbo was anti. Zimbo could potentially have, to ask him yourself, you could.
But that's what I'm saying, though. A lot of people changed on there when they was getting this mad money and nothing ain't been done with the youth. I don't know, but it's just a fucking, speculation.
The money situation is like this, isn't it? Like I said, I have to big up my baby mothers, my mother, blood clot, my pops, the game. You get me, Carl? Without certain things in life, bro, the money from this industry thing, bro, man, they're trying to put boss off, innit? Always remember this, there's nothing, you get me? So obviously, you get me, if man start businesses and liquid enterprises and that, if a certain amount, it probably sounds like big money. So if you've got £100,000 and I've got to pay 10 people for that, for how much money, £1,000 a month, that's 10 months of wage. You ain't got the whole year's wages, bruv. You ain't got the whole year's wages, my brother. But like I said, but to employ 10 people and make sure them 10 people are blessed. I've never took no money from none of these infrastructures or organizations. Like I says, there's not, the money is not no money, bro.
Yeah.
If man do that's £250,000, you get me, £250 a week. 10 by 9 o'clock, 8:30, bro, the phone, fuck, you better fucking, you get me, you understand it, it's mad, so to say this not money, that's 10 people spent it, 5 people spent it, you know, like 10 people spent it, come on, man, it's mad, bro, so to say that anything, you get me, for the man to have a job and you get me to be able to do different kind of things and, you understand, and help put their energy into the community, and you have to go to the schools and mentor and do what they need to do, you get me, and have a space where man can think, bro, because sometimes, it's hard when you ain't got no pee, bro, because you can't get your mind right. To change and elevate, you have to have your mind in a specific place where you're thinking, right.
That's the thing, though. Like, you see, if you, like, documented that, like, going into schools and helping the youths and that, I documented it how the 1 mile away was documented. I think, like, the message would have been a bit more better. You get me, Carl? It just seemed like man was just trying to squash beef.
Bro, that's how it was at the beginning. It was nothing.
That's
what involved in. Like I said, it wasn't even a thing of the squashing beef. It's just a thing of, brother, we know what situation is and we know potential. Like, I got kids that if you watch the documentary, saying, I've got no other reason to get involved in this. I've got 7 boys and my sons are my sons. You get me? And they're a gang amongst themselves. You understand it, bro? So for them to be growing in certain environments, for easy for them to start to represent something, you understand it, bro? That's, you get me? Next thing, you know, it's mad. They come from all them roots from over there. And then they get me, they're involved without even knowing. Because the thing about this gang thing, you remember, it's about 30 years old, nearly 30 odd years, you know. You young gentlemen and that are talking about this gang banging thing. It's nearly 30 odd years, fam. In the 80s, this thing's been going on. Late 80s, early 90s. In 2020. You understand it? Like, it's a deep, like, it's engraved in the, like, you don't understand how engraved it is. So I grew up in the 80s, so I've seen it till now.
You understand it, bro?
So to know what it is and to see, it's a fucking rerun. Like a motherfucker.
Are you deep involved, though? You're just on the outskirts?
Nah, I'm just there. I'm involved. I'm just around it, innit? This is all I know. Like, I don't know nobody else. I got no aunties, no uncles. I live in Anzac, because these are the only niggas I know. So I'm just around it. There's no initiation to no gangs or nothing. These are my bedroom. I love them. You get me? That's it, innit? I do certain things. You get me? I'm trying to get some money. Some man will just do a mad thing. You get me? My place is crazy, bro. I'm trying to get some money. Fuck. Want to shoot where? Who? I don't know the nigga. Remember, like I said, I met Zimbo the first time then, bro. The fuck? That's 2000. Because fucking mean shit was going on since the 90s.
That's the
first time I met Zimbo. Do you remember? 2011, nigga.
2011.
Shit's been going on in 2000s, the 90s. Shoot up who?
So what's coming in the future from
The Lendoffice?
from Flash Dylan's office. Wait, do you get a lot of informal roles?
Brother, I'm going to tell the truth. I'm going to tell you, see, all of the films that we made, it's been made from man.
True.
So, you get me, whether I've had investment or whether I've had, you get me, this or had input or had whatever or not, you get me, apart from, you get me, intent to you, that's the old man, you get me, you get me, everything might
intent most of the jobs, coming, are you in there?
Yeah, God's willing, that's coming real soon, so, yeah. You get me, that's the talk anyway.
Have to come to Brom.
Obviously, when you do the promo run, this is a definite motto.
You need to do your own thing as well, man, just, you get me?
Yeah, like, what about that? Have you got film, man?
I've got my own film that I'm trying to get off the ground right now. So that's OT trapping. You get me? So it tells them more the story about the exploitation of the youth. So you get me? Because everybody wants to be this trap star and everybody wants to do OT. You see, when you're OT, cuz you know, it smells like, looks like, feels like, you know, about wanting to go, oh, my brother, the parcel ain't done. You mean it's slow, dog? Just relax yourself. Fuck him, man. What's this brother talking about? We'll phone you back in a bit, man. And you're just sitting there looking at the phone like, what?
I'm phoning like, me. You're moving like Flash, right? My man's moving like Flash.
But it's reality, though. You know what? But that's the reality of it, though, bro. But I'm saying it's even worse than Pester now, because some niggas, I'm not going to say some use are built for the game and us, Debbie. Then we're on it, like, yo, this is ringing off my phone. Yo, this pack's done, dog. And then some use, you get me, and they grow up in a certain environment, and that's what they need. But I'm not saying that's what they need, because Zim would cost me if I said, yeah, I'm going to say, my door, you mean nobody will need that? But that's what they've been around, and that's what they know. You get me? When some youths are just jumping into some fucking
OT trapping.
So I'm just trying to get the finances together.
Yeah, make sure you split the roles.
Birmingham based.
Listen, you get me? Nah, real talk though. Let me do my thing. You get me? The man is out there, but he wants to invest in that coronavirus times. That man's thinking, what am I going to do with this P or whatever? Not this time. Just watch this. Whatever. I'm thinking, yo, I got opportunity in it. Holler at me. You get me? Like I say, 2020 rolling that same plan. Just holler at me, bro.
Holler. He's got a job opportunity.
Opportunity, some way to make some money on it, legitly. Everything.
Make sure you spread the roles around the city, though, man. Like,
brother, come on, man. My thing's always, I'm doing something in Brom, bro. Come on, man. It's audition. Everybody come true. More than welcome. Like I said, when I did the one day,
the people who got me one day was
the one that came to the audition. So I'm going to big up everybody that came to the audition. But the people that came, that's you. What's it called? That's who it was.
Nah, I need a role, bro.
Man, I can see you in some, man.
Tell me what kind of role. You fucking dickhead. Are you a nub? Huh? You're to backhand you in your face right now. You Flash. I can go get the thing. I manage the informer. Hey. Bro, I can do it on site, you know.
I was thinking more than get me the marijuana kind of stuff.
Yeah, like this.
The yard man plug.
Yeah, the yard man.
Yo,
where's Florida? That phone off?
I was thinking, the division first, man. Florida on the yard. You get me?
Oh, just like that.
Fucking flower shirt on. You get me talking some bullshit. You get me? Flower shirt.
Get me in the movie. I'm acting up.
Some Kingpin shit.
Yeah, give me some. Chop shop on the fucking yacht. You know what the fuck's going on?
Chop on the yacht. That's what it is, bro.
We're fucking with that times. Yeah, we're fucking with that.
Villa.
The
super villain, bro.
Hit that for that. Yeah,
man.
Yeah.
I'm feeling it, bro.
We're gonna make that.
You see what it is? I'm gonna tell the people, and this is the secret. You get me? Thoughts become things. Manifestation. You get me? Law of attraction. All this shit's real. So. When you put something into the atmosphere, you get me, it can become a reality if you believe it.
Yeah.
All you have to do is take the steps and it's yours, man. G.
Yeah, that's an OT trapping.
Hit that, though. You get me.
So in OT trapping, we're doing, actually going to the bandos and filming in the bandos and it's gonna showing be that, everything.
Man, I'm going to show the puss from the injection from the man looking, just taking his cock out while you're there. Yo, bro, I've got to check my jacket over there. I've got the fiver in there.
You're gonna have the fiends coming up to you like, I'm gonna be sick. I need it now.
Going to Mandy's house. Mandy was all right a couple weeks ago. You think Mandy's gone for a couple weeks? Mandy come back. You come back. Mandy's got one leg. Come gangrene. What happened to your leg? I gangrene from the fucking inject. You get me? Smell the fucking the dead the flesh. The going into the yard. You get me? The fucking the lick of the whites. The fucking poker. The fucking the fuck is this?
Fucking hell, lad. Fuck, that's what you're showing us.
Shit, you get me? Give it to them, bro.
So what's the end?
But don't you think, though, like, a documentary will be better?
Nah, because to document it, you'd have to kind of incriminate people and that, innit? Mm. So I can give you the real character. I can give you everything what's real, and I can make you even know, because I'll be know it, innit? I don't know it. You get me? I get me. I heard a story, so I grew up around it. It's like I should say. Mm-hmm. Even so, I grew up around it, so I seen certain things, and you get me? Smelt it. So you get me? Probably followed a man to a place. You get me? Nah, B. It wasn't me, man. Exactly, brandy on your fake, on your leg. Just let me have one day. I was all took. It's wild, bro.
So, are you looking to be in this film yourself, or what?
I want a young star, though, man. Because for the young, it's for the youth, and it's more. It's more for the kids and that. It's more for the younger generation.
Can you touch on it? It's an OT trapping, but can you talk about like? The storyline or anything like that.
We can't give away the storyline.
Not much like that, man.
It's just I can tell you about it's a young man that get me quicks, get that, he gets caught up in something, you get me? Mm. He gets the full experience, you get me, the taste of it, you get me? So it's the thing of, you get me? I'm going to tell the truth in it, because, trapping. Mm. Everybody knows most man don't make it. The 90, what if that, the fucking, what, 98%, you get me? Something happens in it, jail, this, that, the third, something happens, you get me, and take it out, you get me? It's mad. I don't know nobody who's really fucking excel from the thing. Without taking it out and going to jail and time and all these things, the L's are
close. That's what I'm saying, though, man. You gotta make it positive, man. You can't, like, I'm not saying you're gonna glamorize the thing,
but
make the youth them know that ain't the way to
live. It's a horror movie. There's nothing in there. There's nothing glamorous about fucking going OT trapping and making somebody and fucking get exploitation. To tell the gods on the truth and the man them fucking know it. So you get me? I'm not saying nothing that ain't fucking out there. You get me? I know the game's to be sold not told, but you know what it is. You get me? Shit. You understand it? Yeah. Fucking, you get me? So exploitation, fam. You fucking telling you go out there for £200. How much you fucking made £200 my fucking head, like I said?
That's how much money I give him, man. 2 bills.
You get me? And the youth start at 8. You understand? 8 a.m. I mean, you get me? So 10 a.m. He's got that in his pocket. You get me? But he's getting 2 bills for the week.
Okay,
I'm not saying right.
So I don't know, but the youths are happy to go out there, innit? So you get me to go and do, it's better than nothing.
That's how much them men are paying up.
You can't get a job on a normal day. A lot of these youths, you get me, a lot of these youths are going missing. The people think that it's fucking.
I told you, but these youths don't go missing, they go conch, bro.
They go country. So I'm saying it's not, I'm saying it's little kids that couldn't get a job anywhere. You give a youth that's meant to be in school, 200 bills, 2 bills, 3 bills. If you give him 5 bills for the week, you understand it, brother, you've made mad dough. You get me? It's exploitation.
Yeah, that stuff.
You get me? It's expendable. They can go jail and whatnot. Who gives a fuck? There's a million of them.
All right. Just to lighten the mood, Just make sure we got our role. However, you know what I mean? That's it. That's what I was trying to say. Anyways.
I can see, like I said, yeah, man.
Yeah, man, do your thing, man. Put the dreads up, down, big beard. You know what I mean? However you want it. Trust me. Yeah. But yeah, different thing. So boom, moving forward then. So if you're trying to get that movie off the ground, other plans in the future, anything you think we missed?
Next
then?
Film, I'm trying to get off the ground as well. Good to win it, but
you know what?
Just think UK set.
What about you know
just
what?
Put this thing.
Yeah,
UK,
say if, I just want to ask about. It off, kind of, is man. It only like fucking movie Netflix films you dep on? No short films or
trying to get a check if I do it, innit? It's my
check.
Trying to get a check in it.
Well, you're so meant to be
you know what it is? You got
to
do it for the culture of
no, I do nothing if you Google, like, if I pop up in, if any youth phone or anybody pops out.
No, I understand that part. Mm-hmm. What I'm trying to say to you is, like, you know, like this then, for instance, this ain't paying me and him. We're just having a laugh, doing our thing for Brom and that. So I'm saying, when I say short films for Brom, like,
you're meant to be plugging in all the youths. There's beer youths on this thing like that come to where man are based, innit? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And we've got actors, there's beer right, man, and they're looking for...
I'm going to give you the 100, though. You see, my experience of doing the thing, like you said, we just named most of the films. I've been in another film called Road and a couple other things in that, but the situation's mad. So I'm going to tell the truth. To be this actor thing and do this thing, you have to... There's a lot that goes into it. And like I says, I asked a man earlier, I named 5 black actors from England. Name them off your head. I'm gonna leave it.
I can't
I'm saying to you, man, that are working constantly, that you see in television programs and production. I'm saying to you, so the game is very difficult.
I hear that, but you know what it is, though. Man ain't putting up their bread, blood. This is what I'm trying to say.
This is what I'm trying to say.
Man needs to. This is what I'm saying. Even the short film thing. This is what I was saying. The short film thing, that's your advert, innit?
Well, well,
you get what I'm trying to say?
The truth and I hear that. But I just
even your life, bro, you could pattern up that into a film, you know? Fight baby mother's blood.
We're gonna
do it, man. That's what I'm saying, but just picture, D-boy story. Fight baby mother's beer headache. juggling,
boy baby,
school run, school that, run, nursery run,
acting, school
run, arguments over there,
beer argument, weed smoking, PS4 in, you know what I mean. To set the scene, bro. That's a film. I don't know, but that's the scene for the movie.
But listen, make a film based on you. Just as you said, you was juggling whatever you was juggling. Innit? You get what I'm trying to say?
It wasn't juggling,
not
mine.
Nah, that's what
you call it,
man. You know what I mean, though. What I'm saying is,
allegedly.
Allegedly.
Nah. Right, but I don't juggle nothing. But you get me.
Oh, no,
he's kidding. It's lying, but listen.
Juggling what you're juggling, yeah, allegedly. Juggling what you're juggling, allegedly. Yeah. Yeah, and just make a film into it, bruv. Not all the time. Man have to do the guns and drugs thing. You get what I'm trying to say? Man can make a galley's film, you know.
I want to do a galley's film.
That's what I'm saying.
I got one of them in mind as well.
That's what I'm saying, bruv. You could do that, man.
That one's low. No, the mics. I
got some ideas for that too.
Yeah. Yeah, it was good.
I've got some ideas for that as well, so.
Yeah, bro, trust me.
Fingers crossed, you get me? Like I said, with this film's situation, the industry, and that, you get me, man, I'm just learning the game, because when I came into it, it was a lot of money, like it was $750,000, £750,000 that they spent on the film. I was thinking, shit, to make another movie, then, obviously, if we made the intent, and then when I seen, you get me, we pulled, man, and pulled it together, and we got the team together, you can do everything you need to do. If you got, you need some money, though, you do need some cash, but you get me, if you can get everything right. You can do something on a low budget and it can have an effect, you get me? So
So wait then, we're gonna start.
You know what I'm trying to say?
No. It don't matter because we're gonna start wrapping up. We're gonna wrap up now. I'm gonna give the outro speech now. Like, you got anyone to big up? You feel we're good?
Big up everybody. You get me? The whole of Birmingham, you get me? I see the scene, I see everything growing. You get me? Like I said, from 2007 to SG, and that back in the day, you get me? Things was different, bro. Like, you was like, I've got living in a time, and you get me a place.
So, what do you like in the Brum scene now?
I'm feeling everything, bro. Everything that's making some, not everything, bro. Everything I can see, bro. It's everything's lit. You get me? Who the fuck ain't popping? We ain't popping from Brum, cuz. Ain't popping from Brum being serious?
And that's why I want to understand. So you get me?
You get me? If you're respected, even if you ain't respected or not respected, it's respected. It is what it is.
That's why I want you to do a short film or
even some say make it happen.
I
want
to do something with brother.
Some
I want to listen to
like
me.
Even with us.
Just what I'm saying. You don't have to get the trailer down from Penny, you know.
Nah, it's not even that, bro. I'm not saying that. That was mad. That's what I'm saying. I understand that certain things, you get me, is unnecessary spending when you're making movies and that. You don't need certain things. That's where money gets wasted and burnt and you get me, it's mad. But boom, we can do something, man. It's just, you get me, plotting and planning and scheming. Yeah. It's all about, you get me?
True.
Like, plan, that's, we can do everything. Everything is possible, B.
Last question before we wrap up, yeah. You know, on set, are they smoking real weed? It's just a thought.
I was in Jamaica, yeah.
That's different, that's different. That's different.
I know you're going to get me. But
don't even get me. But it's a good question. I've always wondered that.
I don't, like, she's not, they have this, like, to be truthful, yeah.
If I'm on set.
To be truthful, yeah, in one day, we had this thing, like, it's fake. It's a backup kind of stuff.
I see man drawing the thing. If I'm on set, I have to smoke real weed, because, you know what I mean? Just letting them know. Can that run? We'll talk about it in the contract. It's going to have to be in the contract. Ain't smoking no fake weed. None of that. Yeah.
Shit. Nah, man. We get
weed for one, yeah. We're going to blaze that. Right, cool. Blaze that. So, yeah. Keem, any last bits and bobs?
Nah, man. Just keep doing what you're doing for the youths, then, man. You are doing good work in the community.
You're doing good work. We like to have a banter. This is what we're going.
We love it, man. We love it.
Yeah, we like to have a laugh. We like to have a joke. We like to show a different side to the guest.
Yeah.
I'm getting drunk and smoking hella weed, all of that. This is what we're doing. Tell them about the hospitality one more time. You're nice.
Like, listen to me. Food was mad. Big up Chef Walla.
Chef Walla, happy birthday, my killer.
You get me?
I still got my little bit of cackle.
Look at that. You got your cake,
I got my cake too.
Cake.
You get me pudding, so I got pudding and that. You get me? I got wheat. Allegedly.
Oh, sorry. Allegedly. I look at something. It's that thing that's in the films.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what it
is. What talking about, you get me, props. So that's what I'm saying, in the budget, you have to have props, but that's another conversation, but boom.
Listen.
Yeah, so boom, yeah, man. Yeah, big up everybody in here. Big up, you get me, big up the whole team. Big up Trap Trap Podcast, you get me. Thank you, gentlemen, for having me, you get me. It's been a pleasure.
Don't know.
Like I says, the hospitality's been mad, you get me. The drinks, and big up the Caribbean ice drink, blood clot, when you mix it with the fucking white rum. And I can't believe I did the interview like this.
You get me? That's the vibe.
You get me?
You know the vibes. Drinking juice.
You get me? Nothing too, don't talk, nothing too loose.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying to you. Good one, man. It's good one. Me and Akeem back again. Gruesome, twosome. What did I say at the start? Did I say anybody Hardy Boys? Hardy Boys.
Cafu and Carlos.
Now that's next one, man. Don't drop that one on the next one. I'm going to start copying. Yeah, we out though, man. Hold of juice, drink, we hold of vibes, drink of juice, and we don't talk nothing to you, Lise, yeah? Caribbean ice, it's nice.
Big up the chop, chop, blood clot pop. See, that's what I'm saying. I'm getting my words out of my mouth. Big up the blood clot, chop, chop podcast. Yeah. Peace and love, people.
Yeah.
Teams fly in, then they fly out. Gone. Chop, chop, chop it up, you know what we about. Whoosh, chop.